Hello, everyone. My name is Justin St. Ange. I want to thank everyone for allowing me the opportunity to speak with you this evening. I have been looking forward to this event as it is a very exciting time for everyone here with the possibility of becoming a part of something so special. That being said, we will jump right into the PowerPoint presentation. The North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission Law Enforcement Division will be accepting applications from May 15th through June 30th. After the application deadline and the application is closed, there will be an initial background and qualification screening that will take place during July. If you meet those qualifications, you will be sent an invitation to a one-day event where you will complete a physical abilities test, the Nelson-Denny reading comprehension test, and an interview with a wildlife officer. These will take place in July at the San Marcan Training Facility in Jackson Springs, North Carolina. If chosen, you'll receive an invitation for a formal panel interview in August that will also be held at the San Marcan Training Facility. Once the formal panel interviews are complete, those candidates moving forward will receive an in-depth and thorough background investigation taking place in September and October. Those selected will receive a conditional job offer pending a physical and psychological evaluation. These evaluations will be completed in various locations across the state. The recruits chosen for the 60th North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission Basic School will start in January 2024. So, you may be asking yourself, am I qualified to apply for this career? Here you can see listed the minimum requirements to be eligible. You must be 20 years old prior to passing the BLET state exam. The BLET exam for the upcoming recruit school will take place sometime in May 2024. You must have a high school diploma or GED. You must be capable of passing a modified police officer physical abilities test or the POPAT, meet all the background, medical, and psychological requirements previously discussed. You will have to complete the approximate 30-week basic school. Finally, you must be willing to relocate for both your field training assignment and your permanent duty station. Both the field training and permanent duty assignments can be located anywhere within North Carolina. The upcoming basic school will be held at the San Marcan Training Facility. Upon arrival at the basic school, recruits will begin receiving their starting salary and will be placed in dormitory-type housing. Training at the basic school typically takes place Monday through Friday. Recruits are required to reside on campus during this time. They are required to leave the training facility on the weekend, but must return on Sunday night to prepare for the following week's training. During the BLET portion of the basic school, recruits will receive extensive training on various law enforcement duties, including elements of criminal law, arrest, search, and seizure, patrol techniques, driver's training, firearms, subject control and arrest techniques, interview and interrogation, physical fitness training, and so forth. After completing this portion of the training, all recruits will be required to pass the North Carolina BLET state exam before continuing to the advanced training portion of the basic school. During the advanced portion of the basic school, recruits will receive advanced training focused on the primary duties of a North Carolina wildlife enforcement officer. Recruits will receive training on advanced topics such as game warden tactics, advanced control techniques, wildlife identification, wildlife and boating laws, reality-based simunition training, boat operation, advanced driving with the North Carolina State Highway Patrol, covert operations, and various other topics. The basic school is extremely mentally and physically demanding. Hired recruits will be expected to complete multiple PT assessments, pass the North Carolina BLET POPAT, and complete a 5-mile run. Recruits will be exposed to a paramilitary style instruction focused on discipline, teamwork, organization, and attention to detail. This type of instruction will prepare recruits for high-stress situations in the field. Recruits will attend regular instructor-led physical training sessions. They must be willing to work flexible hours, with training often starting early in the morning and extending late into the night. Recruits will also receive scenario-based training focused on realistic law enforcement encounters, exposure to CS gas, as well as the agency-issued taser equipment. Upon completing the basic school, recruits will be sworn in as certified North Carolina wildlife law enforcement officers. There will be a formal graduation ceremony for friends and family to attend. Upon completing the basic school, officers will be assigned a field training location. Before graduating from the basic school, recruits will be notified of their assigned training location with adequate time to search for housing. This training location can be in any of the 100 counties across North Carolina. Trainees will be responsible for providing their own housing for the rest of their careers once they have graduated from the basic school. Officers with families or significant others may elect to bring them to their assigned training location. During this time, trainees will be paired with a field training officer for 6 months. Trainees will work daily with their assigned training officers and be expected to mirror their training officer's work schedule. Trainees will be evaluated on their daily overall performance by their field training officer. Upon completion of the field training period, trainees will be given a permanent duty station. Like the field training assignment, this permanent duty station can be in any of the 100 counties across North Carolina. Officers may reside up to 15 miles outside of your assigned county if approved by the colonel. Officers may apply for a lateral transfer to a vacant position when advertised at any time after being assigned their permanent duty station. Laterals will be granted based on seniority or, in the case of equal time, an interview. Officers can also elect to remain in their permanent duty assignment for as long as desired. If you're fortunate enough to become a North Carolina wildlife law enforcement officer, your daily responsibilities will seldom be the same. While an officer's primary responsibilities are enforcing hunting, boating, fishing, and trapping, you will undoubtedly encounter much more. Coming up, we will look at some of the day-to-day duties, responsibilities, and activities of a North Carolina wildlife law enforcement officer. Wildlife officers are the primary law enforcement authority of all inland state waters. Officers patrol boating on all waters of the state from the mountains to the coast. You can think of wildlife officers enforcing boating laws and ensuring public safety on the water, similar to the highway patrol enforcing laws and ensuring safety on the state's highways and roads. When working boating activity, officers' boating duties consist of patrolling recreational boating activity, conducting routine compliance checks of boating safety equipment, as well as focus on the detection and prevention of careless and reckless boat operation. Another major focus of officers is the prevention of impaired boating by detecting and arresting impaired operators. This is often accomplished through focused on-the-water details and sometimes include multiple agencies. The North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission is the sole agency responsible for investigating boating incidents. These investigations include boat accidents reconstruction, courtroom testimony, and coordinating with media personnel. Officers' boat patrol efforts also include working hunting and fishing activity by boat, conducting pre-launch boating safety check stations, and instructing boating education classes for the public. North Carolina wildlife officers are the primary law enforcement authority in North Carolina to enforce hunting laws and hunting violations on both private and public lands. Other duties will include acting as the lead investigator for hunting incident investigations, instructing hunter education classes, leading programs, and assisting with hunter education tournaments. While it is well known that wildlife officers in North Carolina enforce hunting laws, not everyone may be aware of what is sometimes necessary to detect hunting violations. Detecting these violations is not always an easy task. Officers frequently utilize covert or inconspicuous techniques to apprehend offenders. Some of these tactics can include, but are not limited to, utilizing trail cameras, night vision, drones, thermal optics, ATVs, or our agency's aircraft. Officers will be detecting violations such as night hunting, hunting during the closed season, bag and season limits, manner of take, and many more. As an officer, you will also complete routine hunting checks and make great contacts in the field. These contacts will not always result in an enforcement action. In fact, most of the everyday routine checks as a wildlife officer often end with a positive interaction with the public. Many come with the opportunity to make a lasting impact. Another major part of the career as a North Carolina wildlife law enforcement officer is patrolling fishing activity. Thousands, if not millions of anglers take to our state's waterways each year in hopes of catching the big one. As a wildlife officer, you will complete routine fishing compliance checks, attend and organize fishing events and programs available for the public, as well as detecting and enforcing various fishing law violations such as creel and size limit violations. While trapping is becoming somewhat of a lost art throughout the United States, trapping is still a very prevalent aspect in the career of a wildlife officer. When patrolling trapping as an officer, you will be responsible for trapping compliance checks with the public and ensuring that trapped animals are handled humanely by enforcing all trapping regulations. North Carolina wildlife officers are called upon to complete many tasks that are not always in an enforcement capacity. One of those tasks is to assist the public with human-wildlife interactions. Human-wildlife interactions occur daily in North Carolina and may require the assistance of an officer. Wildlife officers in North Carolina assist the public when capturing, transporting, and relocating wildlife to certified rehabilitators or for relocation purposes. Wildlife officers, commonly referred to as game wardens, are often considered to be the Swiss Army knife of law enforcement. This may be because, while in performance of the duties within our subject matter jurisdiction, officers in North Carolina are often exposed and expected to handle violations that are not necessarily wildlife related. Wildlife officers in North Carolina have full arrest authority. We will sometimes detect and charge violations such as littering, driving while impaired, drug activity, breaches of the peace, and any other threats to public safety. Officers are highly involved in search and rescue efforts, emergency management efforts, as well as assisting local and other state or federal agencies when needed. The starting pay for hired recruits will be between $46,000 and $50,000 annually. Hired recruits will begin receiving their starting salary immediately at the start of the basic school. You will also receive state health care, a 30-year retirement pension with a law enforcement supplement, and a 401k. Other various benefits of being a North Carolina wildlife officer are that you will have a flexible work schedule, varying working environments and conditions, paid holiday and military leave, an agency-issued take-home vehicle, and career development opportunities. Some of these potential opportunities include promotional opportunities, field training officer, general and specialized instructor, specialized training, boating and hunting incident reconstruction, honor guard, special operations unit, swift water rescue, drone operator, and aircraft pilot. As we wrap up this PowerPoint presentation, I want to encourage anyone that is interested in applying for the position, if you haven't already, to begin making yourself a competitive candidate. I encourage you to engage in North Carolina wildlife regulated activities, reach out to a local wildlife officer in your patrol area, for possible ride-along opportunities, and focus on improving your physical fitness. As we previously discussed, we will be accepting applications from May 15th through June 30th. At the conclusion of this event, you will receive an email with a link directing you to our careers page. Please feel free to email us at enforcementjobs@ncwildlife.org for further information. This concludes the PowerPoint presentation. I want to thank everyone for listening. Before I go, I just wanted to say that becoming a wildlife officer in North Carolina is not an easy task. It will require hard work, long hours, dedication, sacrifice, and determination. But if there's one thing I can promise you, it will be worth it in the end. In my opinion, there's no greater career out there.